Probably should have combed my hair. Chimney crown, which is totally cracked. We have had some water leakage problems inside, which is how I know that we have had a problem up here. I got this stuff called crown coat. So what I'm gonna do is take the blue tape and I'm gonna tape around the edge of the chimney to just get a nice clean look. Build up a couple of layers of crown coat around the chimney. There's probably some spots around the outside there that need some additional touch-ups. That is my plan for repairing the chimney, is to use that crown coat. Basically, it just brushes on. Come back and probably do a second coat of it. I'm not sure. We'll just see how it goes. Get a chimney cap on here. So I'm gonna go around and remove all that stuff that's around the outside that's pink. And I'm not sure why we have two chimneys actually on this house. In any case, clear off all of that pink stuff, paint the crown coat onto there. Just used a thicker blue tape to go around the outside. Gone around the whole thing and removed a bunch of the old bits. I don't know about really ripping it all off because I'm, again, concerned that I'm going to end up taking all of this stuff off, and I'm not sure if I should or if I can just fill in with the crown coat here. If I'm doing this wrong, someone can post in the comments and let me know that I've done it wrong. I don't know that I should pull all of this stuff off. Most of it is adhered with caulk that somebody did at some point in the past. In any case, I'm going to start now with the crown coat, and I'm going to go over the top of the existing cement that's there, hoping that it just fills down in between those cracks and creates a nice seal over the top of the chimney, and then we'll come back and chimney cap it. As I'm doing this, I'm realizing I should have taped around both of the chimneys as well. I'm kind of going around the side there and I'm getting it up on the side, so I'm going to tape those and probably try and clean that a little bit off. This stuff is going on pretty thick, but it has to because of the condition of the chimney. I've already probably used an eighth of the bucket. I got the bigger one. Yeah, 2 gallons. I'm hoping that this will cover the whole thing. The side that I started on is actually the worst side. Hopefully I won't need quite as much on the other side, but I think this will be enough. Here are my chimneys all taped up. Hopefully we'll just get a nice clean coat on with everything that will keep the water out that's been dripping in. It's kind of a super thick coat on there. I want to tell you the couple of things I probably should have done differently. Anytime working with mortar, of course, and I'm sorry I'm squinting, but the sun suddenly has become very, very bright. But anytime you're working with mortar, I spray the surface with water first. The other thing that I should have done is use duct tape. I don't know why I used masking tape. That was silly. For some of the gaps where you could see right through in the cinder block or where it had cracked, I would actually have caulked those in. I did do a little bit of caulking, but I would have caulked a lot more because you can see some areas where it's actually dropping, and I'll show those to you, but where it's actually like sinking in. So I've used about 2/3 of the 2 gallons because I had so much damage up here. I would have used less if I had caulked in where it's sinking right there. So I should have caulked that in instead of expecting the crown coat to go across it. But I'll probably do, maybe get some caulk and fill that in and then put another layer of crown coat over the top of that. You can also see how it's really ridgy here. And I don't really like that look. I'm gonna let this dry for a couple hours first. I'm gonna put a layer on, wet the paintbrush just a little bit, and then smooth it out so that it's got a smoother look to it, because I don't really like it not having a smooth look. And that will be it for the crown coat. Overall, you know, it was nice to have some good instructions on the bucket that I read after I put it on there. So I would highly recommend reading the instructions beforehand, because that's what you're supposed to do, and I didn't. Having a bucket of water when you come up on your roof, because now I'm gonna have to climb down off the roof, get a bucket of water, rinse the paintbrush out. I could have just waited up here, let that dry, and then applied the coat that I want that's gonna kind of create the finish on it. After getting it all smoothed out and whatnot, it has decided it is going to start sprinkling, which is not good for this stuff to be able to dry. There's a bunch of water splotches starting to show up on there, and that is not going to help this dry out. Because we're in the mountains, it's never easy to tell when it's going to rain and when it's not. And in this case, it's going to sprinkle today, so I'm going to cover it with some plastic. Leaving this exposed to air would let it dry much quicker, but leaving it exposed to water and rain is going to make sure that all the work I've just done goes away. It's just a drizzle right now, but it could actually turn into rain at some point.
See my shadow there? This is how it sat pretty much all last night. We got a much nicer day today though, so I'm gonna go ahead and take this plastic off. We've got a big chimney cap online from Amazon. We'll get that put on here today after this has a chance to dry a little bit more in the sun.
We got all the tape off and I've got my outside cage basically put together. I've just kind of set it into place here. They said you can either apply construction adhesive like along here underneath to glue it down, or you can use some screws, some of the concrete masonry screws. I'm not gonna do one or the other, I'm gonna do both because I'd rather this thing stay on here and not blow off. 4 screws in, that's what came with it. I've got some more of these, so I may add some more to the sides, but also going to use construction adhesive underneath.
It will be much more difficult to get it square if I stick it to the chimney first and then try and square it up to the holes that are actually in the cap. Put the cap on, then add adhesive to the underside of it, stick it on there, and then pre-drill some holes. If I'm not a professional installer by any means, I'm just a guy who watched a bunch of videos on the internet, and I'm hoping that this video helps you too. I'm always a big fan of Gorilla Glue, at least some of the other Gorilla Glue I've used, and this stuff seems to be very, very sticky, and that is exactly what I want it to be, so I've added a nice, healthy, thick layer on here, just kind of in beads between the potential screw holes. So I'm going to flip this over, set it on top of the chimney, just get it into place, and then I will go ahead and put the screws in as well with the nut driver. Here it is, the final installed chimney cap. There's one thing I would have done differently. You can see on the side here, there's a little gap that's between the metal on the outside and the metal on the inside. I would have stuck this piece on the side. I would have put that inside of here and then wrapped the tab the other way. I did that on the other side and it works much better. If I wanted to come back and clean up along the edges, I could. It was pretty straightforward. Overall job. One thing I would say is my kit only came with 4 masonry screws. I really needed more in order to hold this down with that line of glue underneath in order to get the glue to actually sit on the new chimney crown. I really had to bend it over there. So it was really helpful to have those extra masonry screws to drive into the masonry to hold the new cap in place. I hope you have learned something watching this video. I hope it's been helpful for you, and thanks for watching.